In this video, I just want to talk about some of the myths that are out there about HVAC and electrical and power usage and so on. There's just a couple of myths I want to kind of relate. So maybe you'll have a better understanding of how this the heating and cooling equipment actually works. I'll tell a little story with the first one. And it has to do with this little doohickey. That is a 35 VA control transformer off a gas furnace. When I was early in my career in this business, I came across a home that I went in, their furnace didn't work, they had no heat, and it was an electric furnace. I found that there was no power to the furnace, so I go to the breaker panel, and the breaker, no matter what position you put it into, it was open. And the woman of the house said, well, we turn that off every night. So when they go to bed, they would turn the breaker off every night. And so I'm kind of thinking, why would you do that? And I asked her, I said, well, why are you doing that? They said, well, it's using power all night long. And the electric bill is going to go through the roof. And I said, okay, how do you know it's using power? And they said, well, I can hear this little hum. That's from that little control transformer. Okay, she thought her electric bill was going to go through the roof because the furnace was on all night. Because she hears this hum. Okay, that transformer is for controlling the controls inside the electric furnaces to turn on the elements in the fan. Well, it's a very tiny transformer, you know, it's not very big. And it uses very little power. And when it's off, when it's not opening any of the sequencers or anything like that, it's using almost nothing. I mean, this is 35 VA, that means 35 watts. If this thing was actually operating at full load, it would use 35 watts. It's only using a couple of watts when it's off. And that's just the inefficiency of the transformer. If this thing was using a lot of power, it would get massively overheated. This thing would burn itself up before it could ever use hardly any power at all, actually. So, you need to understand that electricity, for the most part, comes from heat and goes back to heat. If we have a combustion-fired power plant, then we take heat, we make mechanical energy out of it, we make electrical energy out of it, and we send it out. And then if it's an electric furnace, I turn it back into heat. Or if I put it through a transformer, I put it back into heat. So, to use a lot of power, this thing would have had to be some sort of massive thing, and it would get hotter than heck. Well, it didn't do any of that stuff. So, she was not real thrilled that I had to replace her breaker, because that meant two trips. One to identify which breaker was bad, and take down the numbers, and go get the breaker and come back, and she had a bill of about $80. Now, remember, this was 1978. Nine, I think. Yeah, so that was a fairly large bill then. Okay, this is a case of someone thinking all this power is being used, but if it was being used, there'd have to be heat dissipated someplace, and there isn't. It's hard for people to understand that. I try to explain it, it doesn't always work. Okay, that's one case. And I have another one where someone has a furnace. Now this could be a gas furnace, oil furnace, or electric furnace. I'll use electric if that furnace is, say, a 10 kW furnace, and it runs all the time to keep the structure, you know, at a given outdoor temperature, let's say it's 30 degrees outside, and it runs all the time, is it using more power than, say, a 20 kW furnace, you know, twice the size, that only runs about half the time? Okay, the trick here is they use the same amount of power. Just because it's running all the time does not mean that it's using more energy. It's just a smaller heater. The heat loss is the same. So whether it's running all the time or not, or running just a little bit, it uses the same amount of energy. Now, I can take this to extreme degrees where I have a very large furnace in a very small application, and there's some inefficiencies there, especially if it's a gas or oil. But for the most part, it really doesn't make any difference. And then people will tell me, oh, the fan runs all the time. It's going to use all this energy because the fan runs all the time. Well, here's a fan right here. Standard old fan for a furnace. And it runs, okay, let's take the electric furnace. Let's say I have a 10 kW furnace. Okay, that's 10 kilowatts for the elements of the furnace. The fan is running less than 1 kilowatt. So if the fan was running all the time, would that make any difference? I mean, that's, you know, less than a tenth of what the furnace runs. But again, electricity comes from heat and goes back to heat. When this fan runs, any inefficiencies of the motor are turned into heat. I'm heating the structure. If I take this fan and I take a temperature probe right here and I run the fan, I will show on the other side of the fan maybe 2 or 3 degrees temperature rise. That is both the inefficiencies of the fan and the friction of the air. Because when I start moving that air, that loads that fan. So I'm taking something and I'm pushing it, and I'm actually heating it a little bit. So if I have an electric furnace that is 20 kW, and this thing, let's say it's 1 kW, I got a 21 kW furnace. That's what it turns out to be. So all the energy is actually going in. Now, we're talking about air conditioning, it's a little different because it actually adds to the load. But that's not what we're talking about right now. Just what I'm trying to get across is, just because it runs a lot does not mean it uses a lot of energy. It could use a lot of energy, but if the load is the same and I have two different sized furnaces and one of them runs all the time and one of them runs half the time, it does not make any difference. It still uses the same amount of power. That's a very simple concept that an awful lot of folks have a lot of trouble with. So I just wanted to explain that. I hope I've done a halfway decent job of explaining that. So that's it on this one.